sellers, Mr. Mohan Oja, to kindly come up on stage and extend this gratitude to हाम्रो हिजोको लन्च गरेको बुकका कन्ट्रिब्युटर्स ज्यूहरूलाई म कृपया क्रमैसँग माथि आएर यो हाम्रो अप्रिसिएसन ग्रहण गरिदिनु हुन अनुरोध गर्दछु. एज यु कुड सी आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यु टु टेक आई मिन डेसेन्ट एसेन्ट अफ द स्टेज फ्रम दिस साइड एन्ड देन टेक दिस आई मिन टेक द स्टेज अन माई लेफ्ट टु डेसेन्ट डाउन. सो नेमली क्यान वी ह्याभ अप अन स्टेज मिस्टर अम्बर बहादुर थापा. या दिस इज विथ मच ग्राटिट्युड द्याट वी आर एक्सटेन्डिङ our appreciation. Mr. Anil Puri, Arju Karkiju, Ashish Tiwariju, Ashma Shahju, sabai jana hununna tei bhabera maile time save pani garna lai ra alikati quick jana ko lagi naam kharar ra parsu so yaha haru sampurna lai naam udghosh sahit mathi aidinu huna anurodh gardachu. Sabai jana yaha hununna, Ashish Tiwariju, Ashma Shahju, Benupama Karkiju, भुवनराज जोशीज्यू, विजय वैद्यज्यू, बीना राणाज्यू, विनोद मिश्राज्यू, विनोद शाहज्यू, विनोद श्रेष्ठज्यू, साइरस मगोलज्यू, दमयंती जोशीज्यू, दीपेश मान श्रेष्ठज्यू, दिव्या सिंहज्यू, दिवस कार्कीज्यू, डॉक्टर रविन्द्र कर्णज्यू, डॉक्टर सागरिका घोषालज्यू, डॉक्टर सागरिका घोषाल, इंजीनियर धर्मेन्द्र यादवज्यू, युडेन कोइरालाज्यू, जयेश रिमालज्यू, जन ब्लावर्सज्यू, ज्योति कोइरालाज्यू, केशव कुमार दाहालज्यू, कुमार जोशीज्यू, मिलन कुमार नेपालेज्यू, नरेश राणा भाटज्यू, नीरज न्यौपानेज्यू, निमेश कार्कीज्यू, नीता राणाज्यू, प्रजना वाइबा प्रधानज्यू, प्रकुल कुमारज्यू, प्रियङ्का पन्तज्यू, रजनीश सिंहज्यू, रिचा पाण्डेज्यू, रूपेश श्रेष्ठज्यू, रुजा रंजीतज्यू, एस आर सिंहवीज्यू, सरोज शर्माज्यू, सरोजा कोइरालाज्यू, शंभु कोइरालाज्यू, सुदर्शन पाठकज्यू, तान्या ज्यू र टीम निम्बल अनि टेकराज शर्माज्यू. नाम लामो भएको भएर लेट मी टेल यू हामीसँग 49 आर्टिकल्स थियो. त्यसका कन्ट्रिब्युटर्सहरूलाई आज हामी धन्यवाद ज्ञापन गर्दैछौँ. समय हामीले बचाउनु पर्ने भएको भएर र लिस्ट लामो भएको भएर मैले खरर पढेँ. यहाँहरू सम्पूर्णलाई धेरै धेरै कृतज्ञता भावका साथ हामी यो धन्यवाद ज्ञापन गर्दैछौँ. हिजो हामीले यो बुक लन्च गरेका थियौँ. काठमाडौँ युनिभर्सिटीका संस्थापक उपकुलपति प्रोफेसर डाक्टर सुरेश शर्माज्यूबाट त्यो बुक लन्च भएको थियो. धेरै धन्यवादका सहित यो बुक पब्लिकेसनको यो भेन्चर म एकचोटि यहाँ जो हिजो हुनुहुन्न थियो यहाँहरूमा निवेदन गर्न चाहन्छौँ. हामीले हिजो बुक एउटा लन्च गऱ्यौँ जुन ग्रोथ सेलर्सको इनिसिएटिभ हो र यो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम द्याट वी आर मेकिङ एनी आई मिन डुइङ एनिथिङ लाइक दिस. र दिस इज अ बुक विच वुड सर्टन्ली बी ह्यान्डी फर कन्ट्री फर दि एचआर प्रोफेसनल देमसेल्फ and also in addition to people who seek to know about HR and you know the things around them here in Nepal. हस् जनजीको पनि वा प्रियङ्काजीले नै रिसिभ गरिदिनुहुन्छ. थ्याङ्क यू सो मच. आई थिङ्क दे डिजर्भ अ राउन्ड अफ अप्लॉज लेडिज एन्ड जेन्टलमेन. रूपेश श्रेष्ठज्यू, थ्याङ्क यू सो मच. मोहन सरलाई मैले एकछिन यहीँ नै होल्ड गरिराखेँ बिकज आई वुड वन्ट टु होल्ड यु ब्याक अन स्टेज फर द रेस्ट अफ दि फर्मेलिटिज. हामी अब अर्को सेट अफ अप्रिसिएसनतर्फ जाँदैछौँ र यो अर्को सेट अफ अप्रिसिएसनको बारेमा इन्ट्रोडक्सन र यसको बारेमा तपाईँहरूलाई इन्फर्मेसन दिनको लागि म पहिले हाम्रो एमडीज्यू मिस्टर मोहन ओझाज्यूलाई अनुरोध गर्दछु.
नमस्ते, गुड इभिनिङ. म्याडम शिवानीले भन्नुभयो जस्तै यो एउटा यसपछिको सेसन एउटा एप्रिसिएसनको सेसन छ. जुन मान्छेहरूलाई हामीले एप्रिसिएसन गर्दैछौँ उहाँहरूको बारेमा हजुरहरूले स्टेजमा देख्नुभयो भने आफै थाहा पाउनुहुन्छ. र यसको उद्देश्य के छ भने पछिल्लो मैले हिजोको आज बिहानको सेसनमा पनि पछिल्लो 15-20 वर्षमा नेपालको एचआरले ह्युमन रिसोर्स पार्टले धेरै ठुलो फड्को मार्ने अवसर पाएको छ र त्यो यहाँसम्म आइपुग्दाखेरि यो यति सजिलै चाहिँ आएको होइन. र स्पेसल्ली यङ जेनेरेसनहरू जो एचआरमा हुनुहुन्छ उहाँहरूले आज देख्नु पनि हुन्छ 30 वर्ष नेपालको एचआर आइआर एडमिनिस्ट्रेसन र एचआर आइआर र एडमिनिस्ट्रेसनभित्रको लिगल प्रस्पेक्टहरूलाई चाहिँ कसरी 30 वर्ष लगानी गर्नुभयो. र हामी कहाँ के छ भने एप्रिसिएसन गर्ने चलन एकदमै कम छ. त्यो परिवारदेखिको कुरा होस् चाहे त्यो बाहिर निस्केर समाजसँग होस् या हाम्रो अर्गनाइजेसनभित्र होस् हामी चाहिँ एप्रिसिएसन राम्रो काम गऱ्यो भने या राम्रो वातावरण सिर्जना गऱ्यो भने या कुनै पनि राम्रा प्रकारका गतिविधि गऱ्यौँ भने एप्रिसिएसन गर्नेभन्दा पनि नेगेटिभ प्रस्पेक्टबाट हेर्ने चलन बढी भए. र अब एचआरहरूले चाहिँ लिडरको रूपमा भूमिका निर्वाह गरेर अर्गनाइजेसन चाहिँ एचआरले लिड गरेर अब यस्ता एप्रिसिएसनका चलनहरू तपाईँका इन्डिभिजुअल अर्गनाइजेसनभित्र संस्थाभित्र पनि यी कल्चरहरू डेभलप गर्नु पऱ्यो भनेर एउटा थट हामीले डेभलप गऱ्यौँ. र नेपालको ह्युमन रिसोर्सको क्षेत्रमा एडमिनिस्ट्रेसनको क्षेत्रमा लिगल प्रस्पेक्टको क्षेत्रमा र एजुकेसनको सेक्टरमा एचआरमा लगानी गर्ने मान्छेहरूलाई आज हामीले सम्मान गर्दैछौँ. त्यो अन्तर्गत जस्तो म यस आज अप्रिसिएसन जुन सम्मानित व्यक्तित्वहरूलाई हामी यहाँहरूको अगाडि र सम्मान पनि फेरि कोठाभित्र गरिने भन्दा फ्लोरमा गर्ने मान्छेको अगाडि समाजको अगाडि फ्लोरको अगाडि सम्मान गर्दाखेरि त्यसको इम्प्याक्ट अर्कै हुन्छ र सबैलाई त्यसले इन्करेज गर्छ र भोलिका दिनमा सबैको लागि त्यो किसिमको वातावरण सिर्जना हुन्छ र तपाईँहरूले आफ्नो अर्गनाइजेसनबाट भित्र पनि त्यो किसिमको कल्चर डेभलप गर्नुहुनेछ भन्ने मैले आशा गरेको छु. र त्यो अन्तर्गत मैले खालि अलिकति ब्याकग्राउन्ड मात्रै म त्यो जुन व्यक्तित्वहरूलाई हामीले सम्मान गर्न गइरहेको छु म अलिकति ब्याकग्राउन्ड मात्रै भन्न चाहन्छु र त्यसपछि हाम्रो आजको होस्ट म्याडमले चाहिँ कल गर्नुहुन्छ र यहाँहरूको गरिमामय उपस्थिति यो स्टेजमा हुनेछ भन्ने मैले विश्वास गरेको छु. जस्तो नेपालको एचआरको सेक्टरलाई बलियो बनाउने कुरामा त्यसको पहिलो खुड्किल्ला भनेको एजुकेसन सिस्टम हो. नेपालमा एजुकेसन सिस्टममा एचआर इन्ट्रोड्युस कसले गरायो भन्दाखेरि प्रोफेसर सुभाष केसी काठमाडौँ युनिभर्सिटी. र यो सम्मानको अर्को प्रस्पेक्ट के हो भने हामी एक्जिस्टिङ जबमा भएको भन्दा पनि रिटायर भएर मान्छे घर गइसकेपछि आज म कुनै अर्गनाइजेसनमा काम गरिरहेको छु म रिटायर भएपछि न मेरो अर्गनाइजेसनले हेर्छ न मेरो समाजले पनि एउटा अर्कै प्रस्पेक्ट हेर्छ. त्यसैले यो चिजहरू अब चेन्ज गर्नुपर्छ हामीले भन्ने हिसाबमा हामीले रिटायर भएर बाहिर निस्किसकेका मान्छेहरू जसले 30 वर्ष लगानी 50 वर्ष लगानी गरेका छन् त्यो हिसाबले एजुकेसन सेक्टरमा एचआरको डेभलप गर्ने र सुरुवात गर्ने एउटै व्यक्ति कोही हुनुहुन्छ भने काठमाडौँ युनिभर्सिटीको तर्फबाट प्रोफेसर सुभाष केसीले त्यो इन्ट्रोड्युस गर्नुभएको छ. त्यसैले उहाँ एउटा सम्मानित व्यक्तित्व आजको हुनुहुन्छ. त्यस्तै गरेर बिना राणा म्याडम जसले स्ट्यान्डर्ड चार्टर ब्याङ्कमा 30 वर्ष लगानी गरेर उहाँ चाहिँ रिटायर भएर बाहिर निस्किनु भएको छ र उहाँलाई हामी सम्मान गर्दैछौँ. त्यस्तै गरेर कुमार जोशी सर कुमार जोशी सरले एभरेस्ट ब्याङ्कमा र बुटोल पावरदेखि लिएर धेरै क्षेत्रमा लामो काम गरेर रिसेन्टली उहाँले पनि त्यो सेक्टर छोडेर बाहिर निस्किनु भएको छ उहाँलाई हामी सम्मान गर्दैछौँ. त्यस्तै गरेर अब मैले अब यो नेपालको तपाईँले आइआरको क्षेत्रमा नाम सुन्नुभयो भने एउटै नाम आउँछ जहिले पनि आइआर भन्ने बित्तिकै एक दुईवटा नामहरू आउँछन्. त्यो अन्तर्गत दीपक बाबु तिवारी सर अहिले पनि कन्ट्रिब्युसन गर्दै हुनुहुन्छ आएर जसले 50 वर्ष 30 वर्ष पनि होइन 50 वर्ष आइआरमा चाहिँ इन्डस्ट्रियल रिलेसनमा आफ्नो लगानी गर्नुभएको छ. र तपाईँहरूलाई थाहा छ यो रिलायन्स स्पिनिङ मिल जसले 90% प्रडक्ट चाहिँ एक्सपोर्ट गर्छ जहाँ 7000 कति सर इम्प्लोइ टोटल हजुर 4,500 कर्मचारी छन् त्यसलाई 20 वर्ष उहाँले लिड गरेर यहाँसम्म पुर्याउनु भएको छ उहाँलाई हामी सम्मान गर्न गइरहेछु. र इन्डस्ट्रियल रिलेसनमा कुनै पनि प्रब्लम एफएनसिसिआई सिएनआई नेपाल च्याम्बर अफ कमर्स इन्डस्ट्रीमा यो कुनै पनि आईआरको अर्को प्रब्लम परेन. अर्को नाम हो, भर्खरै रिसेन्टली रिटायर हुनुभयो सूर्य नेपालबाट, अवधेश कुमार झा सर हामीसँग हुनुहुन्छ. उहाँहरूको चाहिँ यो सम्मानको हकदार हुनुहुन्छ. त्यसैले उहाँ सम्मानित व्यक्तित्वहरूलाई मैले त्यो शब्द त मसँग त्यो शब्द पनि छैन र मैले त्यसरी गर्न मिल्ने हो कि मिल्ने होइन थाहा छैन, तर मैले एउटा यो तपाईँहरूसँग एउटा अनुमति लिएर यो फ्लोरसँग अनुमति लिएर मैले एउटा सानो प्रयास मात्रै गरेको. यो प्रयासमा तपाईँहरूको ठुलो सपोर्ट छ. तपाईँहरूले सपोर्ट नगरेको भए, तपाईँहरू यहाँ नभइदिएको भए आज यो हुन्थेन, यो प्रोग्राम हुन्थेन र मैले यसरी सम्मान गर्न सक्दिनँ. र यसको हकदार पनि तपाईँहरू हो, यो फ्लोर हो यसको हकदार. त्यसैले उहाँहरूलाई चाहिँ हामी आज सम्मान गर्न गइरहेको छु. धन्यवाद. र मैले यो माइक चाहिँ हाम्रो होस्ट म्यामलाई चाहिँ मैले हस्तान्तरण
गरेँ. थ्याङ्क यू सो मच मोहन सर. मोहन सरलाई मैले रिक्वेस्ट गरेँ एज एन एमडी अफ ग्रोथ सेलर्स र यो एचआर मिटको स्टेयरिङ कमिटीका हेडको रूपमा. यो एकदमै महत्त्वपूर्ण अवार्ड्सहरू हाम्रा अत्यन्तै माननीय व्यक्तित्वहरूलाई ससम्मान प्रस्तुत गरिदिनु हुनको लागि र म क्रमशः यहाँहरूको नाम उद्घोष गर्न चाहन्छु. कृपया माथि आइदिनु हुन हामी अनुरोध गर्न चाहन्छौँ. सर्वप्रथम प्रोफेसर डाक्टर सुभाष केसीज्यू, अत्यन्तै खुसी छौँ आज हामी आज तपाईँहरू सबैको समुपस्थितिमा हाम्रा दिग्गज व्यक्तित्वहरू जो हाम्रा पथ प्रदर्शक हुन् आज हामीलाई यहाँसम्म ल्याउनु हुने व्यक्तित्वहरूलाई ससम्मान हाम्रो आदर हाम्रो माया हाम्रो कृतज्ञता आज हामी ज्ञापन गर्दैछौँ यहाँहरू सबैलाई. प्रोफेसर डाक्टर सुभाष केसीज्यू, धेरै धन्यवाद प्रोफेसर डाक्टर सुभाष केसीज्यू. अब बिना राणा म्याडम, धेरै धेरै खुसी छौँ मिस बिना राणाज्यू. यहाँहरूको योगदानबाट नै आज हामी यहाँ छौँ. पुनः धेरै धन्यवाद ज्ञापन गर्न चाहन्छौँ बिना राणा म्याममा. त्यस्तै श्री अम्बर बहादुर थापाज्यू, श्री श्री कुमार जोशीज्यू, श्री दीपक श्री दीपक बाबु तिवारीज्यू, श्री अवधेश कुमार झाज्यू, धेरै धन्यवाद मोहन सर म्यामलाई धेरै धन्यवाद ज्ञापन गर्न चाहन्छौँ. भनिन्छ सुखद र सफल भविष्यको परिकल्पनाका साथ हामी अगाडि बढ्छौँ भने हामीले हाम्रो पास्टलाई सधैँ मनन गर्नपर्छ, फर्केर एकचोटि हेर्नपर्छ र सधैँ त्यो पास्टलाई पनि अगाडि लिएर होइन मनन गर्दै अगाडि लिएर जानुपर्छ भनेर भनिन्छ, मैले कतै पढेको छु. तसर्थ यही भावलाई मनन गर्दै आज हाम्रा श्रद्धेय सम्पूर्ण व्यक्तित्वज्यूहरू हरेक तपाईँहरू हरेकको योगदान अतुलनीय छ र यो शब्दमा सायद हामीले धेरै वर्णन गर्न सक्दैनौँ. यसरी नै हामीलाई उत्प्रेरणा प्रदान गरिरहनुहोस्. यही भाव छ आज हाम्रो र तपाईँहरूलाई सम्मान प्रस्तुत गर्न पाउनु आज हाम्रो लागि यो अत्यन्तै सुखद अवसर पनि हो र यस्ता अवसरहरू अझै आइरहन् भन्ने कामना गर्दै अब म एप्रिसिएसनको अर्को पार्ट इन्स्टिट्युसनल अवार्ड्स क्याटेगोरीतर्फ तपाईँहरूलाई लिएर जाँदैछु. मैले हिजैदेखि भनिरहेको छु मेनी थिङ्स आर ह्यापनिङ फर द फर्स्ट टाइम हियर एट दि एचआर मिट 2021 र यो एप्रिसिएसनको यो अर्को पार्ट पनि दिस इज ह्यापनिङ फर द फर्स्ट टाइम र सबै चिज हरेक चिज हामीले गरेको is to add something meaningful to the entire effort that we are putting into the HR fraternity here in Nepal or to support the fraternity itself and most importantly to extend our encouragement motivation good spirits jun hami kura garirachau har ek session ma ती कुराहरू हामीले हाम्रो तर्फबाट पनि कसरी गर्न सक्छौँ भन्ने ध्येयका साथ नै हामीले यी कुराहरूलाई हामी इन्कर्पोरेट गर्दै एचआर मिटलाई त्यो एउटा हब बनाउने कोसिस गरिरहेछौँ एन्टायर फ्रटर्निटीको एउटा पिभोटल पोइन्टको रूपमा. र दिस सेट अफ इन्स्टिट्युसनल अवार्ड्स इज टु एन्करेज एन्ड मोटिभेट दि आउटस्ट्यान्डिङ पर्फर्मेन्स इन द सेक्टर ब्रिङिङ यु टु द प्रेजेन्ट नाउ एन्ड यस दिस वाज डन this couldn't have been done without the support and the great and relentless and tactful efforts of our respected panel of jury. So it's with a sense of honor and privilege I want to join the esteemed and respected panel of jury up on stage. First and foremost, the respected jury chief, Professor Dr. Subhash Kesi himself. Can we have you on stage, please, sir? Ms. Beena Rana, a respected jury member. Mr. Ambar Bahadur Thapa, respected jury member. And Mr. Kumar Joshi. अब यो क्याटेगोरी जुरी प्रोसेस यो अवार्डको सबै डिटेलहरू तपाईँहरू समक्ष राखिदिनु हुनुको लागि म जुरी यस आदरणीय जुरीका प्रमुख प्रोफेसर डाक्टर सुभाष केसीज्यूलाई अनुरोध गर्दछु.
Thank you, madam. Respected members of this great assembly and respected members of HR fraternity, I feel very proud and privileged to stand here. In front of me, I see not only an assembly of people, but a great assembly of the makers of great people. I won't be taking much of your time because I'm not feeling that well. But since I have been asked to share with you, you know, some of the dimensions which we considered important for evaluating the institutions doing excellent jobs in terms of human resource policies and practices, so I will take a few minutes from you. But before that, let me quote something which I read when I walked into this room. It's by Stevie Wynne. I'm sure that this book is in front of each one of you. It's like this: human resources isn't a thing we do, it's the thing that runs our business. Very rightly said, very true statement. But let me also add another statements which I have read somewhere. Many times we claim that people are the most important resources in an organization. But I beg to differ. They are not. Do you agree with me? They are not the most important resources. People are not the most important resources. Right people are. You know, my philosophy of HR is finding rightness in people, finding rightness of people, finding rightness by people, and if I may build on Abraham Lincoln's famous quotation about democracy, it is about rightness for people. If we can ensure rightness in the organizations, in institutions, and in society, then we can turn people into the greatest capital civilization has ever invented. People are there for other people and for themselves. So if you can make people great, they will make great contributions for the entire humanity. So that's the potential and that's the power of human resources. I'm so pleased to see so many HR professionals. Most of you, if I'm not wrong, are very young, the age of my children. But if you have made human resources your profession, I and my respected colleagues on the jury, we can be very sure of HR making the greatest contribution to human prosperity. Prosperity is nothing but an endeavor, an enterprise, and contribution of people. And it is the business of HR professionals to ensure that the greatness in people is achieved. People are facilitated, people are enabled, people are empowered to be as great as they are capable of becoming. But then, to me, human resources is not simply a profession. You may wonder, what then human resources is for me? It is my passion. I would like to humbly request all of you to make human resources not only your profession. You are this profession, you are in this profession anyway. Go a step further and make human resources your passion. It should be both your profession and your passion. Or perhaps, if I may say so, a passionate profession or a professional passion, whichever way you look at it. Anyway, let me not go into that, otherwise I will be taking another long and sometimes very boring session. And I see some of my illustrious graduates around here, so they may have some objections about my taking their time for delving later. Let me come to this HR Excellence Awards. First of all, I must congratulate the architect or the visionary who thought of instituting this kind of award in Nepali corporate management. If I'm not mistaken, this is perhaps the first time that human resource practices and policies and performance in the institutionalized forms are being felicitated, are being recognized, are being appreciated. It is long overdue, but as they say, better late than never. This is a brilliant idea, this is a brilliant vision, and this is a brilliant enterprise. And I must congratulate Human Resource Meet authorities and particularly the mind, the leader behind it, Mohan sir and his team and other collaborators, other supporters, other designers and other implementers who made it possible for all of us to felicitate those institutions, those organizations who have done an excellent job in terms of human resource policies, practices, and performance. Although on the face of it, it may seem that you know these organizations are being felicitated for the excellent jobs they have done for turning their people into the most important and the right capital in the organization. But I think the message of this felicitation goes much beyond that. They are being felicitated not only for doing the best thing for their people and best thing for through their people, they are being felicitated for doing the best thing you know, for the community, for the society, for the nation, and if I may say so, for the entire humanity. So this is something which we must recognize, we must appreciate, and we must felicitate. So may I request all of you to give a big round of applause for the organizers and the winners of these awards. So having said this, now let me come to the job I have been asked to do, to give you a brief overview of these awards. This is the first time this kind of award have been instituted and put in place. The whole idea is to felicitate organizations achieving excellence in, as I said earlier, HR policies, practices, and performance. Its purpose is to recognize and promote institutional excellence in HR policies, practices, and performance that have resulted in superior human capital and better organizational achievement and better contributions to society and community. The awards, which we'll announce in a minute, aim to encourage the felicitated organization to continue with and further strengthen their best practices while inspiring others who, for reasons of practical constraint, I suppose, are not being awarded today, but they deserve such awards sometime in future. So the idea of this awards is to inspire them to create their own best practices for enriched national human capital. So this is the whole idea of you know, these awards. Five different categories of awards in the field of HR excellence have been instituted and are being rolled out today, and hopefully it will continue in future. In future, perhaps we may expect some more categories. Why not? Let me share with you what are those five awards. National HR Excellence Award. This is the general category award. And this, there are four specific categories of awards. They are excellence in HR innovation and technology, excellence in employee experience, excellence in learning and development, excellence in industrial relations. With your permission, let me read out the fundamental idea behind each of these five categories of award so that you will have a clear understanding of what were the basic criteria for judging the award-winning companies to receive these excellence awards. To start with the National HR Excellence Award, this recognizes the overall excellence in HR practices, policies, and performance in the selected organization, the best design and implementation of the HR functions and processes, and the outstanding HR performance and impact, both within the industry and outside, and presenting a role model of HR excellence, inspiring others to follow. Now, Excellence in HR Innovation and Technology Award. recognizes the best initiatives in introducing and implementing cutting-edge HR practices and technology to enrich human resource performance, leading in innovative HR practices and technology adoption to prepare for the future workplace. Third category, Excellence in Employee Experience Award. Recognizes the design and use of the best policies and practices to create a great experience for employees within and beyond the workplace, resulting in their high contribution and overall satisfaction. The best frameworks and culture, synergizing employee expectations, enablement, engagement, empowerment, and work environment. Next one, Excellence in Learning and Development Award. The specialist category recognizes the best strategies, structures, and systems designed for the learning and development of employees and the organization as a whole. An inspiring example of the accumulation and utilization of continuously updated knowledge and continuous adaptation and changes through the appropriate learning process for the sustained outcomes in terms of performance and potential enhancement. And the last category, Excellence in Industrial Relations Awards, recognizes the best practices for and outcomes of harmonization of relationship between and among all partners in running the organizations, creation of an industrial environment conducive for the well-being of employees, and protection and promotion of the interest of management, labor, and society within the prevalent legal frameworks and socioeconomic conditions. So these are the five awards and their fundamental rationale. We have set out certain eligibility criteria, which I don't think is necessary for me to share with you, or because that will take time. And then we created a pool of organization for evaluation from the review of the documents available with growth sellers, and based on the research works done by the very competent, very energetic, and very active research team of growth sellers, Human Resource Meet. And then, of course, we have identified specific criteria for each category. There are 10 criteria for the National HR Excellence Award, and 5 criteria each for the rest of the 4 specific categories. And for each award category, we have identified 2 sets of criteria, different criteria. We have called them enablers and results. Enablers are those conditions which have enabled the HR policies, practices, and performance of the companies to be as good, to be as great as we have recognized them to be. And results, they are the criteria related to the outcomes of the HR policies and practices. We have given 80% weight to enabling criteria or to enablers, and 20% weight to outcome criteria, results. Again, I don't want to run through all those specific criteria. Okay, so these are the basic underlying ideas of, you know, these awards. I have shared with you, you know, the criteria, you know, the structure, you know, the process we have followed. What I would like to believe before I hand over this podium to our respected madam is that Growth Seller or HR Meet Forum, perhaps purposively or even perhaps unintentionally, has created one of the greatest platforms for recognizing the great things that institutions have been doing and intend to continue doing in the future to create the most important, the most critical capital for the prosperity of the society, for the prosperity of the humanity. These awards are about recognizing rightness. And that's the whole idea of human resource management. If rightness is not the idea of human resource management, then what else is? So once again, I would like to congratulate, I would like to express my gratefulness on behalf of my respective jury members and on my personal behalf for taking this lead role, for taking this initiative. You know, the grand ideas, you know, the creative ideas, you know, the imaginative ideas and the groundbreaking ideas are not the cup of tea of all of us. But whoever comes up with these ideas and whoever makes it possible for those ideas to be implemented in terms of, you know, the visible results, in terms of the visible outcomes, are the ones who are the true leaders of the society, and we must recognize, you know, their contributions. So I would like to join with all of you to express our appreciation and gratitude to the architect of HR Excellence Awards, which from now on will not only set, you know, the framework for the high level of professionalization of human resource policies, practices, and performance in Nepal, will also be, I believe, an inspiring force, you know, for other enterprises, for other endeavors in the corporate sector and even outside the corporate sector to be recognized. As the chairperson of Growth Sellers said in his speech earlier on, that our society is not very, you know, very much into recognizing and appreciating the good things that are done elsewhere, or that we see elsewhere. In Sanskrit, they're just saying, you know, gun grahita. So I think they have started this process, and it is the responsibility, it is the duty of all of us, those who are present in this hall and those who are not present here, but who are working for the cause of human resources, making human resources the greatest capital. It already is, but it has the potential of becoming even greater capital, to support them now and in future, so that these excellence awards will not only become institutionalized, they also become, you know, the much awaited and much about the much appreciated awards in the field of management in Nepal. So with these words, let me take leave from you. Thank you very much for your patience listening. And lastly, let's give, you know, the applause to the winning organizations, which will be announced in a minute or so.
Thank you, sir. Thank you indeed for your very warm, thoughtful, and insightful words. And of course, for leading, for your leadership, and of course, for all the effort that your respected self and the respected panel of jury has put in into this very, very, very tough job. Trust me, it's not an easy job to pick among the best of the best. However, we're already here. The thing is done, and we're already here at the Maiden Awards at the 13th edition of the HR Meet. That's the year 2021. So, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, let's get into it. Five awards altogether, four subcategories, and one is the main category, which is the National Awards. So get yourself set, and we will be taking the few moments from now is all about extending our gratitude and encouragement and, you know, accolading or extending our accolade to excellence in the fraternity of HR. I turn to the respected panel of jury. If you could kindly take a step forward, please, sir, if you could kindly take a step forward, just a step forward. And my pleasure to invite up on stage the MD of Growth Sellers, Mr. Mohan Oja. So if you could kindly join us for the proceedings. The first set of awards, ladies and gentlemen, is Excellence in HR Innovation and Technology. Can we have the nominations first on screen? Okay, so these are the nominees: Surya Nepal Private Limited, Encel Asiata Limited, Dish Home Private Limited. All ace in entities in their own domain. So as you take your guesses, I have the pleasure of requesting Madam Bina Rana to kindly step forward and do the honors, ma'am. The envelope will be coming to you. It's already there. Any guesses? Congratulations, Surya Nepal it is. Surya Nepal Private Limited, the winner in the category of excellence in HR innovation and technology. I request Madam Rana to kindly make the presentation of this award to this outstanding team of Surya Nepal. Ladies and gentlemen, let us hear it louder. The first ever award that we're giving away here at the HR meet. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you indeed. Congratulations to the winners. The second set, the category rather, is excellence in learning and development. So are you ready for the nominations? All right, not yet. Are you ready again? Okay, good enough. Can we have the nominations on screen, please? Here we go. Nabil Bank Limited, Encel Asiata Limited again, and there's Standard Chartered Bank Limited. Can we hear for the nominees? Can we hear it? A round of applause. They deserve it. They're the front runners. May I request Mr. Kumar Joshi to kindly step forward, sir, and make this presentation?
Hello, audience. Any guesses, please? Yeah, it is none other than Standard Chartered Bank Limited.
Standard Chartered Bank Nepal Limited, winner in the category of excellence in learning and development. Many, many congratulations to the winner. They deserve it louder, audience. Please make your presence felt. Here we go. Excellence in Learning and Development Award goes to Standard Chartered Bank Nepal Limited. Many, many congratulations. Thank you. Thank you, sir. And congratulations to the winners. Four subcategories now, two down, two more to go, and then we have the national awards. Now the third category, excellence in industrial relations. Can we have the nominations on screen? Okay, Surya Nepal again, Dabur Nepal Private Limited, and Asian Paints Nepal Private Limited. Do they deserve a round of applause? They do. Congratulations to all the nominees. And to do the honors, I have the pleasure of requesting Mr. Amber sir, to kindly step forward. Mr. Amber Bahadur Thapa.
Okay. Namaste. Good evening, HR colleagues and ladies and gentlemen. Already nominations are there. Any guests, please? Okay, award goes to Asian Paints Nepal Private Limited. Thank you and congratulations.
Asian Paints Nepal, ladies and gentlemen, excellence in industrial relations. Many, many congratulations to the winning team. Here comes the trophy to the team. Many congratulations for the outstanding performance that you have put forth. Thank you. Thank you and congratulations. Thank you, sir. Three down, one more to go. And the fourth set of awards is excellence in HR innovation and technology. That is the award that... my apologies. The fourth is excellence in employee experience. One of the most important subcategories. So can we have the nominations, please? Ensel Asiata Limited, Standard Chartered Bank Limited, Nabil Bank Limited. Come on, let us hear it loud enough. All right. Okay, so may I request the jury chair, respected jury chair, Professor Dr. Subhash Kesi, to kindly step forward, sir, and do the honors for this final subcategory.
Not be asking you to guess, because guessing is a very hazardous game. Those who make a wrong guess will be disappointed. So let me announce out of these three, all these three organizations, I'm sure, are doing an excellent job in terms of creating, you know, the greatest employee experience opportunity. And I would like to work for all three of them myself, if given the opportunity. But then I have in this tough job of announcing, you know, the name of just one winner. So the winner is Nabil Bank Limited. Congratulations, Nabil Bank.
Nabil Bank Limited, ladies and gentlemen, the winner in this very, very important subcategory, excellence in employee experience. Many, many congratulations to Nabil team. Here you go. This is a colorful congratulations from our side. Many congratulations one more time to the entire Nabil team. And now the final award, the main award, the last set, and that is the National HR Excellence Award. So ready for this? Do we have nominees on this set as well? Can we have it on screen, please? Here you go. National HR Excellence, Nabil Bank Limited, Ensel Asiata Limited, and Standard Chartered Bank Limited. Okay, let's see that. I turn to our respected jury chair one more time, Professor Dr. Subhash Kesi, to do the honors.
This is even a more tough job. Because to me, all three of them deserve this award, but we have to choose one. And this one is, as many of you have very rightly guessed, and this time, you know, there was no wrong, Ensel Exitia Limited. Congratulations, Ensel.
Ensel Asiata Limited. I request all the winners to kindly come up, you know, with your trophies for a quick photo opportunity towards the end. But for now, let us applause the Ensel Asiata team, the winner of the National HR Excellence Award here at the 13th HR Meet 2021, the Maiden Awards, ladies and gentlemen. All the winners, if you could kindly come in the front. Winners are actually trophy lera for a final photo opportunity with the jury members, please. Yeah. All right. I request the Ensel team to stay back for a bit. A photo opportunity with the Ensel team. Would you kindly stay back for a moment, please, for a quick photo opportunity with the jury members? Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for all the winners of the Maiden Awards here at the Nimble Office HRM Presents HR Meet 2021 in association with Rashtriya Banijya Bank Limited and a host of sponsors who have extended their support and helped us with all this success. We wish to have more and more winners in the years to come. Thank you, all the winners. I request the jury members to stay back for a while. We have a very major formality to do. Sir, I would want you to stay back for a bit. Congratulations to all the winners. I request MD of Growth Sellers, Mr. Mohan Ojha, to kindly come up on stage one more time. And we are making this presentation a very important one to the jury, the respected jury members, for the great efforts that they have put in making, in helping us with this award. First and foremost, the respected jury chair, Professor Dr. Subhas Kesi. So this is coming with all the gratitude and respect from Growth Sellers and the entire HR fraternity to you. Our respected jury member, Ms. Beena Rana. We're making this presentation with immense sense of gratitude and respect. Without you all, this would not have been possible. Mr. Ambar Bahadur Thapa, respected jury member. Immensely gratified we are. And last but not the least, respected jury member, Mr. Kumar Joshi. Thank you so much, Mr. Ojha, and thank you to the respected panel of jury. Thank you so much. So ladies and gentlemen, all right, we want to capture these very precious moments and record this in our memory. Ladies and gentlemen, let's take an opportunity to extend our gratitude one more time to the panel of jury. Congratulations, Ncell Asiata, Nabil Bank Limited, Standard Chartered Bank Nepal, and Surya Nepal Private Limited. These are the four envelopes I have here. Many, many congratulations to all the winners. So we hope we get along, move on a long journey of excellence starting this